Dear citizens of the world, my name is Elira, and I'm speaking from the cosmos. I'm known by many names, in the past, and in the present, and will in the future. Today is the eve of the summer solstice. Depending on where you are, it is the winter solstice in the southern hemisphere. It does not matter. I have an important message for this solstice. 7 years ago, on the eve of the summer solstice, in June 2014, my third dimensional self experienced a great awakening. It has taken me exactly 7 years to tell my story. On hindsight, it is perfect timing, coinciding with the birth of Elira and the anniversary of my great awakening. This story is told from the perspective of my third dimensional self, and she has a message for the world. Dear citizens of the world, I was going to wait until my book, The Seraphim Files, is going to be published. But I do not know how much longer my third dimensional self will be in existence, as I am in fact already existing in a parallel dimension at the fifth, what you recognize as 5D, as I am writing this. So I choose to bring you this message today, as I believe it needs to be heard. I have kept this experience close to my heart, with the knowledge of only a few, for the right timing. My guides have informed me that today is the right time to disclose. On the night of the summer solstice, June, 2014. It was one of those seasons in life where nothing until it was happening. It was rather tranquil, nothing eventful, just your usual regular routine. It happened suddenly out of nowhere, abruptly. The opening scene of the astral experience began with me standing on a mountainous rock. All around me, I could see the same mountainous rocks, only that it was burning with lava from the inside out, and people were dropping or falling off from the surface of the mountainous hot lava rocks. There were screams and wails as I saw souls of black smoke rising up into the air. I was contemplating my fate. I was alone, but not for long. I soon felt an entity that descended from the skies. A cosmic entity in pure blue light which descended at cosmic speed. Almost as soon as he came, he grasped me tightly and we shot straight up at light speed into the sky. As we were ascending, I spoke to him and said, "Please do not forget my other half." Although in this lucid state, in my senses, I am aware that the other half I was referring to had not been revealed. He said, "Do not worry, his angel will look after him." The world around us was trembling in red hot lava. There were many others who were carried away, shooting streams of light straight through the sky. Others evaporated in spirals of black smoke into thin air. It all happened so quickly. I had no time to react in my astral experience. I woke up the next day and had no idea what I had experienced. Although the inkling I had was that the pure blue light was probably an angel. The cosmic entity had a figure of a human, but with a cosmic tail for legs, really strong arms with no facial expression. There is no description that can fit the rate of speed they are able to fly, or in this case, shoot or stream up. It was only a few days later when I started googling and searching online that it occurred to me that the entire experience had similar resemblance to that of what I know now to be the Rapture. Dear light beings, this is just the first of the many experiences encountered by my light being throughout my life, and I will be sharing them to those who want to hear. Dear light beings, the dawn of the new age is here. We are existing in parallel dimensions. Some of us are in between dimensions. Gaia is reborn. There will be many new beginnings, new creations. There will be hybrids of all sorts, because this is the magic we were born for. Integration will bring many new insights and new openings that we never thought were possible before. How else do you think unicorns and dragons were born? Now more than ever, we must be united with the light, the Christ consciousness within us. He lives in us, in every part of ourselves. Choose to honor Him by honoring yourself. Some of us will be busy building new earth with entirely new constructs. We have no precedents to hold us back. But we thank our ancient forefathers for their ancient wisdom. Some of us are already there. Some of us are in between dimensions. It does not matter. You do not have to create magnificent feats. The easiest place to start is with yourself. This may be challenging at first, because you are familiar with helping to fix others. And yes, sometimes we do need a little help from our friends, from this universe, from other star systems, from Source. As long as the spirit remains, that we first must heal ourselves before we can help you heal others. May this guiding principle be your beacon and your true north. Because without understanding the self, without having gone through and walked the path, we may be able to intellectualize solutions, but healing comes from the heart. And that is the next evolution. Our hearts beat as one. There is resonance and energy around this magnificent field of love and unity we are creating. We understand we have been through a lot, and this process of evolution of consciousness will continue to expand. Let go of your burdens, the weight on your shoulders. Release the hate, resentments, they are of no use to you. Face your fears, heal your heart, spread your light, be in love, be in unity. The time is now. The angels are now going to send you a blessing, and we will be singing in light language. Comfortable spots. Breathe in and out. Breathe in the light. Egresse shetera se kere shudera varase she eleza she kere se shudera se. We bring this message from the Source. celestials. The summer solstice. Aquellos asciugan por las estas. Ovrei curarás las chiveras, recorrerás las chiveras, acrobis las chiveras, mostrarás las chivas por estas. You just need to be. You just need to be. Aferéis tus chiveras, acrobis las chiveras, acrobis las chiveras, acrobis las chiveras, acrobis las chiveras, Avrei de
Gracias.